differentiation. You know the chapter continuity is deleted from this syllabus. This year, then differentiation. There are some functions: composite function, implicit function, logarithmic function, and parametric function. And from this function, first we take composite function. Composite function means function of a function. Then we take the theorem of composite function. Theorem. In theorem, y equal to f of u is a function of u. Is a function of is a differentiable. Function of u and u equal to g of x is a differentiable function of x, then the composite function, then composite function f of g of x is a differentiable function of x, then show that dy by dx equal to dy by du into du by dx. Another theorem. This is theorem. Then we take the proof of this theorem. For you. Y equal to f of u and u equal to g of x are the functions and u is not a constant function. Theorem, there are three functions like y, u and x. So we take the small increments in x, u and y. Delta x, delta u and delta y with the small increments in x, u and y corresponding to the small increments. Let delta x, delta u, delta y be the small increments in x, u and y respectively. Then we take the function del y by del x equal to del y by del u into del u by del x, or write it as del y by del x equal to del y by del u into del u by del x. Then taking limit delta x tending to 0 on both sides, then we get limit delta x tending to 0 del y by del x equal to limit delta x tending to 0 del y by del u into limit delta x tending to 0 del u by del x. As delta x tending to 0 delta x tending to 0, del u tends to 0, then
limit
delta x tending to 0, del y by del x equal to limit delta x tending to 0, del y by del u into limit delta x tending to 0, del u by del x. Then here we get limit del u tends to 0, del y by del u into limit delta x tending to 0, del u by del x. This is equation 1. In equation 1, as y is a differentiable function of u, as y is a differentiable function of u, and u is a differentiable, u is a differentiable function of x, then therefore limit del u tends to 0, del y by del u equal to dy by du, and limit del x tends to 0, del u by del x equal to du by dx. Therefore, RHS of 1 exist and finite. Then, hence from 1 and 2, limit delta x tending to 0, del y by del x equal to del y by del u into del u by del x. Then, equation 3 exist and finite. Therefore, LHS of 3 exist and finite. Therefore, limit delta x tending to 0, del y by del x equal to dy by dx. Therefore, equation 3 becomes dy by dx equal to dy by du into du by dx. And you know the equation limit, that you write that equation. Limit delta x tending to 0, del y by del x equal to limit delta x tending to 0, del y by del u into limit delta x tending to 0, del u by del x. Right? Equation 1. This is the proof of the theorem. Dy by dx equal to dy by du into du by dx. We take the problem on this theorem. First problem is, differentiate the following with respect to x. If you solve the theorem and you are given the problem on the theorem, then you solve that problem as per theorem. Suppose here we take the problem, differentiate the following with respect to x. That is y equal to, problem is log y equal to square root of x square plus 1. Y equal to log of x square plus 4. We are given the problem y equal to log of x square plus 4. With respect to, then dy by dx equal to, by that theorem, put x square plus 4 equal to u function. Then y becomes y equal to log of u. you know, on left side there is function of y and right side function of u. So differentiate y with respect to u. Then here we get dy by du equal to 1 upon u. And here we differentiate this u function, u equal to x square plus 4. Then du by dx, here we have to differentiate u with respect to x, du by dx equal to 2x. Then by that theorem, dy by dx equal to dy by du into du by dx. Here dy by du is 1 upon u and du by dx is 2x. Then here we put the value of u. Then here we get 1 upon x square plus 4 into 2x. If it is compulsory only for when we have given the theorem, otherwise we use the another 2x square minus 7 raised to power 5. Here 3 is constant. Differentiate the following with respect to x. Here function is y equal to 3 upon 2x square minus 7 bracket raised to power 4. Here y equal to, we write 3 is example. Differentiate the following with respect to x. Problem is y equal to 3 upon 2x square minus 7 raised to power 5. Here y equal to, then if differentiating both sides with respect to 2x. First we write this function y equal to 3 into, here you know the function is 2x square minus 7 raised to power 5, and that function is in denominator. For differentiating we take that function in numerator. Here we get 3 times 2x square minus 7 raised to power minus 5. Then differentiating both sides with respect to x, both sides with respect to x, here we get dy by dx equal to 3 times, you know the formula, derivative of x raised to power n. Derivative of x raised to power n is n into x raised to power n minus 1. Then here also, this is not complete derivative. There we find the derivative of base. Here you know ddx of x is 1. So we write standard formula, derivative of x raised to power n equal to n into x raised to power n minus n. Then by that formula we differentiate this function. Here the value of n is minus 5. So here we write minus 5 into 2x square minus 7 raised to power minus 5 minus 1. Then here we get minus 15 into 2x square. It is not complete derivative. Here we also write ddx of 2x square minus 7. Then here we get 2x square minus 7 raised to power minus 6. And derivative of 2x square. Here 2 is constant and derivative of x square is 2x. So here we get 4x. Then final answer is minus 60x into 2x square minus 7 raised to power minus 6 is the final answer. Its final answer, this type we can write this type also, minus 60x upon 2x square minus 7 raised to power 6. This is the final answer. And then next problem, differentiate the following with respect to x. Y equal to y equal to 3 upon 5 times cube root of 2x square minus 7x minus 5 raised to power 3. this type of formula. Here we write y equal to function is in denominator 3 upon 5 times denominator function. We can write as 2x square, write as 2x square minus 7x minus 5 raised to power. Here we write 5, so sorry, 5 raised to power 5 by 3 denominator function. Then dy by differentiating both sides with respect to 2x, dy by dx equal to here 3 by 5. Here the denominator function we can take in numerator, ddx of 2x square minus 7x minus 5 raised to power minus 5 by 2. Then here we get 3 upon 5. Derivative of this is by using the formula ddx of x raised to power n. Here the value of n is minus 5 by 3 into 2x square minus 7x minus 5 raised to power minus 5 by 3 minus 1 is minus 8 by 3. And derivative of base 2x square minus 7x minus 5. Derivative of this is 4x minus 7. Then here cancelling 5 and 3 is cancelled. Then here we get final answer equal to final answer is 4x minus 7. Here we write 4 and final answer is 4x minus 7 upon 2x square minus 7x minus 5 raised to power 8 by 3 is your final answer. Differentiate the following with respect to x. Differentiate the following with respect to x. Next problem. Y equal to cot of log x upon 2 minus log of cot x upon 2. Dy by dx equal to, you know the derivative of cos x, derivative of cot x is minus cos x square x. Then by that time here we get derivative of cot of log x by 2 is minus cos x square log x upon 2 into derivative of ddx of log x upon 2 minus, then derivative of log of cot x by 2 is 1 upon cot x upon 2 into derivative of cot x upon 2 is minus cos x square x upon 2. Then here also 2 is cancelled and minus minus is plus. In next step here we get minus cos x square log x upon 2, and derivative of log x upon 2 is, derivative of log x is 1 upon x. Here we get 1 upon 2x. Then here minus minus plus, and 1 upon cot is tan x into cos x square x. This is the final answer. Then next problem. Next problem, a table of values of f, then g, f dash and g dash is given below, in table, that is below is in table. First x, f of x, g of x, f dash x and g of g dash x. at x equal to 2, the value of f of x is given, g of x is given, f dash x is given, and g dash x is given. That is the same thing for x equal to 4 and x equal to 6. Now our problem. If rx equal to f of g of x, then find r dash 2. To get r dash 2 from rx, first we differentiate rx. Rx equal to first problem. This is first problem. Rx equal to f of g of x. First we find r dash x. R dash x equal to, here we get f dash of g of x. Then again find the derivative of g of x. Derivative of g of x is g dash x. Then here we get f dash of, no, we write first r dash 2. First write r dash 2 equal to, replace x by 2 on both sides. Then here we get f dash of g of 2, f dash of g of 2 into g dash 2. You know, f dash, the value of g of 2, x equal to 2, for x equal to 2, the value of g of 2 is 6. So here we write f dash of 6 and g dash of 2. G dash of 2 is 4. You know, g dash of 2 is 4. Here we write 4. Then we find the value of f dash of 6 from this. F dash of here x equal to 6, f dash 6 is minus 4. Then here we get minus 4 into 4. Final answer is minus 16. This is your first problem, minus 16. Okay. Next problem is if rx equal to g of 3 plus f of x, then find r dash 4. Find r dash 4. For this we differentiate first rx. Rx equal to g of 3 plus f of x. Differentiating x with rx with respect to x, here we write r dash x equal to, in this side, g dash of 3 plus f of x into derivative of 3 plus f of x is f dash x. Here we write f dash x. Then here we get g dash of 3 plus f of x into f dash x. The value of, no, here we write the value of r dash 4. So here replace x by 4. Here we get r dash 4 equal to g dash of 3 plus f of 4 into f dash 4. Here we write g dash of, here no, g dash of 3 plus, the value of f of 4 from table is 3. The value of f of 4 is 3. Here we get 3 into f dash 4. The value of f dash 4 is, what is the value of f dash 4? F dash 4 is 5. Then here we get g dash of 6 into 5. Then you know the value of g dash of 6 is 7. Here we get 7 into 5 equal to, final answer is 35. Final answer is 35. So r dash 4 is 35. Then next problem. Problem number 3. Problem number 3 is if sx equal to g of, if sx equal to f of 9 minus fx, then find h dash 4. We write sx equal to
f of 9 minus f of x and we find s dash 4. So first we find s dash x. S dash x equal to f dash of 9 minus f of x and into derivative of 9 minus f of x. Here 9 is constant and derivative of f of x is f dash x, and here we take minus minus f dash x. Then we write f dash of 9 minus, no, first we write here s dash 4 because we find the value of s dash 4. Here we replace x by 4. S dash 4 equal to f dash of 9 minus f of 4 into minus f dash of 4 minus f dash of 4. Then here we get f dash of 9 minus f of 4. The value of f of 4 is 3 from table, minus 3 into minus the value of f dash 4. The value of f dash 4 is 5. Value of f dash 4 is 5 into minus 5. Here we get f dash of 9 minus 3 is 6 into minus 5. Then we find the value of f dash 6 from table. The value of f dash 6 from table is minus 4. Then here we get minus 4 into minus 5. Therefore, s dash 4 final answer equal to 20. Our final answer is s dash 4 equal to 20. Then next problem, last problem. Here, right? See, yeah. See, third number. Then we take our now number 4. Problem number 4. Here is problem number 4. If Sx equal to g of gx, then find L dash 6. Sx equal to g of gx. G of gx. Then S dash x equal to g dash of gx into g dash x into g dash x. Then here we write g dash of the value of g of x. The value of g of x is, no, here we write first s dash 6, sorry, s dash 6 equal to g dash of g of 6 into g dash of 6. Then g dash of the value of g6, g6 is from table is 2. Here we get 2 into g6 into g dash 6. The value of g of 6 from table. The value of g of 6 from table is 2. And the value of g dash 6 from table is 7. What is the value of g dash 6? Is 7. Then the value of g dash 2 from table is 4. So here 4 into 7 equal to 28. Final answer s dash 6 equal to 28. Write down this. Next problem, write down, differentiate the following with respect to x. Problem is y equal to power log of sin x to the base 2 plus 9 raised to power log of 9 raised to power, sorry, 9 raised to power log of cos x to the base 3. Here we get, first we write it as y equal to, differentiate the following with respect to x. Next problem, y equal to 4 raised to power log of sin x to the base 2 plus 9 raised to power log of cos x to the base 3. You know that, you know 4 is the power of 2,
So here we write 2 square. Raised to power n log of sin x to the base 2. Then plus here we get 3 square. Raised to power log of cos x to the base 3. Then we write that 2 raised to power log 2 raised to power sin square x. Plus here we get 3 raised to power log 3 raised to into cos square x. Then here by logarithmic formula, here 2 raised to power log 2, here we get 1. Then here it sin square x by logarithmic formula, sin square x plus cos square x y equal to. Then different, then we get here, you know the fundamental identity, sin square x plus cos square x equal to 1. So we will write 1. Then differentiating y with respect to x, dy by dx equal to 1 is constant, we get answer 0. Then next problem. Sin square x square minus cos square x square dy by dx equal to, here you know the function sin square x square and here cos square x square, you know the derivative of x raised to power n, we write n into x raised to power n minus 1. So here we get 2 times sin x square, here we get sin of x square into derivative of sin of x square, the derivative of sin of x square is cos of x square, here we get cos of x square. Here again derivative of minus cos square x, we write 2 times cos of x square into derivative of cos of x square, derivative of cos of x square is minus sin of x square. Then here we get 2 times sin of x square, no, here the derivative is 2x and here also derivative of x square is 2x, here the derivative is complete now. Then here we get 2 times sin of x square into cos of x square into 2x and 2, here we get 4x. Then again here minus minus plus 4x into sin of x square into cos of x square. You know here in first term 4x and second term, and in second term 4x, taking 4x common, in bracket we get 4x into, here we get sin of x square, here we get sin of x square into cos of x square plus sin of x square into cos of x square. Addition of bracket is 2 times 4x into 2 times sin of x square into cos of x square. Then you know the formula sin 2x is sin 2x into cos 2x. You know this formula for sin 2x is 2 sin x into cos x. So by that formula here we get 4x into sin of 2x whole square is the final answer. 4x into sin of 2x square. Then next problem. Differentiate the following with respect to 2x. Next problem. Log of 4 raised to power 2x into x square plus 5 upon square root of 2x cube minus 4 bracket raised to power 3 by 2 y equal to. On right hand side we apply the logarithmic rule, here multiplication, here here is multiplication of two function and here division of two function, then by logarithmic rule here we get log of 4 raised to power 2x plus log of x square plus 5 raised to power 3 by 2 and minus log of 2x cube minus 4 raised to power 3 by 4. It is correct. You know the square root of 2x cube minus 4 is 1 by here we get 2x cube minus 4 raised to square root. So here this is 2x cube minus 4 raised to power 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 raised to power 3 by 2 we get here 3 by 4. Then next here we get 2x into log 4 plus 3 by 2 into log x square plus 5 minus 3 by 4 into log of 2x cube minus 4. Then differentiating both sides with respect to 2x, then dy by dx equal to, in first term 2 log 4 is constant and derivative of x is 1, so here we get first term 2 times 2 is constant and derivative of log of x square plus 5 by formula 1 upon x square plus 5 into derivative of x square plus 5, here 5 is constant, so derivative of x square is 2x, and in last term 3 by 4 into derivative of 2x cube minus 4. 3 by 4 into derivative of log of 2x cube minus 4 is 1 upon 2x cube minus 4 into derivative of 2x cube minus 4 is 6x square. Here 4 2s are 4, dividing by 2. 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Then again here 2 2 cancel. Final answer is 2 log 4 plus 3x upon x square plus 5 minus 9x square upon 2 into bracket 2x cube minus 4 is final answer. Y equal to root cos x plus root of cos root x. Differentiating both sides with respect to 2x. Dy by dx equal to derivative of cos x is 1 upon 2 times root cos x into derivative of cos x is minus sin x plus. Then derivative of root of cos root x is by formula 1 upon 2 times root of cos root x into derivative of cos of root x. Here we get minus sin x upon 2 times root cos x plus 1 upon 2 times square root of cos of root x. Then derivative of cos of root x is minus sin of root x. Then again derivative of root x is 1 upon 2 root x. Then final answer minus sin x upon 2 root cos x. Here minus sin of root x upon in denominator is 4 root x into cos of root x and then here again square. Then this final answer. Therefore dy by dx equal to minus sin x upon 2 times root cos x. Here minus sin of root x upon 4x into square root of cos root x. Final answer. Then next problem for homework. Write down some problem. First problem. Differentiate the following with respect to 2x. Homework. Square root of 3x minus 5 minus 1 upon square root of 3x minus 5 raised to power 5. First problem. Then second problem. Y equal to log of square root of 1 minus sin x upon 1 plus sin x. Next problem. Y equal to log of
e raised to power x square into 5 minus 4x raised to power 3 by 2 upon cube root of 7 minus 6x. 7 minus 6x and we are bracket. Then number 4, y equal to x square plus 4 raised to power, raised to power 4 upon square root of x square minus 5. Four problems. We completed tomorrow this one.